Katie. I'm a third year Doctor of Veterinary Medicine student at the University of Melbourne, and we're based at the Werribee campus. A typical day for me would be waking up around 8 a.m., having breakfast and coffee with my housemates, and then we usually all carpool together to uni, which is just 5 to 10 minutes away. And then in the mornings, we usually have 3 or 4 lectures, followed by a nice hour-long lunch break. And then afternoons for practical classes, which can either be in the labs, post-mortem room, or obviously working with live animals, or just practicing our clinical skills. And these usually go until around 5 o'clock. And then we all drive home together again, hang out. We usually have movie nights at home or little study groups. And yeah, that's the life of a vet student. Now we're in the UVet hospital, where this is an actual proper veterinary hospital that our students get to use and practice our skills with real animals. And this is Ellie here. She's one of the staff doggies. And we just practice doing a mock consult where I do all the normal things in a normal checkup. So take her heart rate, breathing rate, temperature. I'll have a look in her ears, her eyes. Look at her beautiful little teeth through all this hair. So she's looking really good, and luckily she's really friendly. Yeah. This is everyone's favourite coffee van. And with the new constructions, we will be getting a cafe at uni, but in the meantime, we have this coffee van come every single day. And cheers everyone up. So here we're behind the UVet hospital, which is where all the final year students come to study while they're also doing placement and rotational work within the hospital. And so this is the computer lab where everyone can do their own work. We also have tea rooms, lounge room, and different study areas, so that students can just spend their spare time together and working on their projects. This is a folder all with animals that have swallowed things that they shouldn't have. And there are so many corn cobs for some reason. So here we can see that this dog has swallowed a belt buckle along with what looks to be some nails or needles. So here we can see that we have a dog that would have been feeling quite ill, possibly vomiting. And upon x-ray, we found that it has very clearly eaten an earring. And so that's going to have to come out immediately. This is Kendall Hall College, where students can stay, so we do have residents. And so we've got the dining hall, and this is the fun room where we can hang out in our spare time. There are lots of different events that are run by the student body. We have things like barn dance, which is the best event of the year that we had about a week ago.
Yeah, last week everyone gets dressed up in their flannies and boots.
And we all do, yeah, we all do line dancing, and we have a caller who teaches us how to do the do-si-do and all that. And that's probably one of the funnest nights of every single year. We also have things like vet cruise, vet ball. And then we have the appreciation groups that run their own events. So I guess within vet there are our own little special people. Like there's the wildlife appreciation group, which is WAG. There's HAG, the horse appreciation group.
Shag,
that's for sheep. BAG for bovine, all your cattle people.
And then there's the marine, MAG.
Marine.
And then there's student welfare.
Yeah, so the SWAG, that's student welfare. So we're allowed to come here and play with the horses at lunch times when they're not being used for pracs. And these are just teaching horses, so they're handled every day by students. So they're generally really well behaved and patient.
And this is Stella. Okay,
this is Stella.
She's a beautiful horse.
Yeah. She's a standard bred. So she may have won once upon a time being a trotter or a pacer used in racing. But now she just gets to hang out with us. So we're in the clinical skills lab here, which is where students are allowed to come any time that they'd like just to practice their skills, whether it's suturing like these girls, or like our little friend here, we can practice preparing a surgical area. So this is used to create a sterile area. So we're gonna wipe it down, scrub it around, practice wiping in the right directions before surgery. And we can practice scrubbing in as if we're about to do a surgery. And yeah, there are lots of different models around the room so that we can practice anything we'd like. Then we'll look in with the light, seeing where you're going to place your tube. And so the dog's already sedated, so this should be nice and relaxed and easy to move. And you always want to avoid having a hand in here in case it does have a reflex to bite. This is our lovely horse model, where it's super realistic without entry points, and we can practice entering as if we would in a real horse without the welfare concerns of it actually being alive. So I can go in, I can feel intestines, they're really squishy. I can go down, I can feel the bottom of the pelvis. Under there, that feels like a uterus. I can go up, feel more intestines. And it's all really squishy inside, so it's really realistic and weird. So as you can see, our campus is currently under construction, and by the end of the year we should have a new super duper teaching facility, which is going to be 5 stories high. Each floor has a different theme, so we have one for surgery, one for practicing clinical skills, one's going to be, the bottom floor is the library, and so this is going to be super high tech. It's going to become the biggest and I think the best veterinary school in the Southern Hemisphere. And yeah, so that's gonna be ready at the end of the year. So any future students coming here are gonna be able to use these facilities. So this is a house of 4 of us vet students, and we are only 10 minutes away from campus, so it's super easy. Sometimes we come home for lunch if we want. And yeah, because we're far out from the city, rental's really cheap here, so we have a really nice house between us. All right, so obviously as vet students, because we love animals so much, in our spare time we look after some as well. So for the moment we have 3 little kittens. This is Sven, one of the little 3 that we have, and he's the smallest. And so yeah, we're bottle feeding them milk, getting up at night, we have to toilet them. And yeah, we love them. This is Ziva the rat. She's one of our pets. She's super friendly, she just hangs out with us while we watch TV. She gets fresh dinner every night. She's my favourite because she's got a little ringtail possum tail. And she's a very special rat because she's already been through 2 surgeries to remove big tumours, and she's doing super well. She's over 2 years old and she's really healthy and really friendly, aren't you? At the University of Melbourne, we're really lucky that we've just started a new program where in third year you start selecting what track you want to be a part of. So it's sort of like a specialisation, so you can choose between horses, production animals, small animals, or then what's called GITCH, which is what I'm doing. So it's government, industry, conservation, health. So So I chose that because it's all about wildlife, conservation. We get to visit zoos. We also do a lot of industry and governmental work, so learning about what other roles you can do have later on rather than just being like a clinical vet. And then in fourth year in vet, it's lecture free and it's basically all just preparing you for the real world. So it's all just placements and rotations. You have to do a certain amount of weeks in different practices. So whether it is with large animals or small animals, or then there's the sort of the miscellaneous category as well. And so that's just really building up your skills and getting ready to have a real job one day. So we're really lucky on top of all of our theory that we do a lot of practical work. And so we do this in the form of placements. So in the first 2 years, we did 12 weeks of pre-clinical placements. So this was mostly farm work. So you get to organise that yourself, whatever you're interested in. So I did work with pigs, with sheep, with horses. I did a fair bit with wildlife. I went and worked with turtles. Some people went overseas and worked with elephants or, you know, apes, whatever you can choose for yourself. And then once you get into third and fourth year, you start doing clinical placement. So I've already done 4 weeks working in different veterinary clinics. And so then you just get to shadow the vets and learn how to do simple things such as, you know, giving injections or taking bloods or whatever they let you do at the clinic. All it takes is a good average, and then you get to write 250 words about yourself. So make sure that you have had lots of experiences. For example, volunteer with animals, go do some work at a clinic, just get out there. You can go volunteer at a farm, just hang out, get those experiences up, and then that'll make you sound really good in your application. And if you can back that up with good grades, then you should be cool. So if you've enjoyed this video and you want to learn more about top universities in the world, then just like and subscribe.